Hello friends, welcome to all of you in my YouTube channel, that is IAS IPS exam study center. So today I teach you human trafficking, gender and environmental issues. So this is a new chapter. So if you want to write down anything, you can write down. So let's start the discussion. Human trafficking, gender and environmental issues. Insurgency, terrorism in South Asia is also faced the emerging as an area with the lukewarm and gender sensitivity, which finds expression in female infanticide, female malnutrition, denial of basic health care and education to the girl child, and increasing rate of violence against the women. A recent study on education and girl child in South Asia gives a very detailed picture of the kind of deprivation and victimization they face. The factors that are responsible are not only of social or religious character, but are also found in extreme economic condition of abject poverty and political situation like war and conflicts. Human trafficking and fierce trade in South Asia are almost beyond the control and related to wide array of factors, starting from mainly social tradition role of demarcation to situation related to the problems of internally and displaced person IDP. Refugees and migrants often force prostitution is accompanied by kidnapping and violence. However, violence against women as an act occurring at random, a presentation on the various aspects of such violence relates to the plethora of acts and ranging from the child infanticide to be forced prostitution and marital rapes, honor killing, and declining state of women health, and particularly vulnerability to the dread HIV and denial of medical attention. It is needless to say that there is a non-disassociable relation between the population and explosion of health hazards and the host of other problems. A large section of the South Asian population comprises of children and women who are victims of various health problems. It is reflected of the failure of the governments to achieve the much required population control. However, what is the serious concern to the South Asian countries are rising threats of the epidemic health and hazards ranging from post-natural disaster and epidemics of the tuberculosis and HIV/AIDS. A World Bank report adequately analyzes the fallout of the health problems, particularly the epidemics attack, that's certainly applicable to South Asia. In many developing countries, injuries, HIV/AIDS and TB could have several points of the GDP growth rate by winnowing the number of the prime age of adults. Together with the increase in outlays on those suffering from the chronic and ailments, these diseases could be also substantially raises expenditure on health care. The states are the further challenged by the inability to control the movement of infected persons across the region as IDPs as illegal migrants. The success of democratic welfare policy depends much on the reasonable role of the society and governments as well as education, which is indispensable ingredient in the making of conscious and capable society, is able to contribute to positive functioning of kind of socio-political system that we see in South Asia. Unfortunately, the religion feature rather sad record of the successful literacy. It is interesting to learn that the children who have been enrolled in some kind of school are above 80% of most South Asia. However, it is this threatening to learn the fraction of children who are able to continue up to fifth grade completing primary education is rather low. In fact, in India, the percentage of children that continue with their education is less, 60%. Pakistan is known as a nation of dropout and literacy rate is less than 50%. Other nations are doing not much better. Poor and inadequate education lead to further social complication and stagnation of economic performances, unemployment, social disharmony, rise in socio-economic crimes, and overall failure in democratic system to achieve stability and progress. Moreover, the young generation without proper education fall prey to cheap unskilled labor and making the issue of child and forced labor a serious issue all over the South Asia. Around the turn of the country, a report by the World Bank Group see that even after the conservative estimate of 20 to 30 million child labor forces live in the five large South Asian countries, the picture is likely to lack bleaker as in 2000. It was reported that in 2000, ILO projected 601 economically active children in Afghanistan, 2069 girls and 3032 boys between the age of 10 and 14, representing 24.2% of this age group. Forced child labor is also associated with other kind of insecurity problem, such as forced recruitment in terrorist outfits. In Afghanistan, children were pulled out of school to join various armed groups in Sri Lanka. LTTE, also known as the recruitment of children as fighters. Therefore, states are feared to face the challenges of dissident movement so long as the forces take advantages of the uneducated younger generation in South Asia. Even environmental issues are gaining increased attention as they have begun to challenge the concept of good governance in South Asia. The issue of environmental problem must be seen in close association with the concept of development, which is fundamental to the success of democracy, welfareism in South Asian system. However, delicate balance between the environmental security and the need of economic development has been seriously disturbed by the chronic problem of poverty. Therefore, the idea of sustainable development can deliver and desired good when poverty is lesser challenges. As long as poverty dominates the development of trajectory, threats of resources and depletion increase, and so do conflicts over them. Over exploitation of resources will exacerbate it, and perpetuations of those denied resources. Therefore, there continues to be a relentless process of bickering and conflict more often than not accompanied by violence. Over land masses to be mutually reinforcing but also creating the vicious circles which was engulfed in large sections of the masses of South Asia, the challenges of the environmental insecurity for the states of the regions is not likely to be quelled in the near future because of the international drawbacks within the latter. Thank you, friends. If you like my video, like it, share it, and thank you.